Lord, we just thank you for how you have been blessing us. And Lord, we are praying that as we go into this message, the true way of holiness, help us to get the very best that you have for us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, that in this our generation, we'll still be showing people that there are people that are still depending upon God, that they refuse to be corrupted by the things in the world.
Amen.
And they want to live for you. Oh Lord, make us to be like that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you because for your answer. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
In the morning we looked at the call to holiness. And now we are looking at the way to true holiness. This message of the morning is a message of challenge. The message of this evening is more of a practical realization of that challenge. How do I get into this experience of holiness in a practical, tangible way? God has called me into holiness, but how do I practically realize it? So tonight's message is more of a practical realization. And when God has done it in your life, it will be easy for you to live the way God wants you to live. Righteousness will mark your life. And we're talking about, you see, and it's important for, there are so many believers that are afraid because of the systems of the world. But you don't have to be afraid because of the systems of the world. I remember, you know, and like we said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things will be added unto you. You know, let serving God be your priority. I remember 1984, when I finished my first degree at the University of Ife, and then I went for a youth call. My youth camp was in Auchi Poly, in Auchi. And then we finished 1 month, woman over, did all the things at Auchi Poly. And we were to choose, we were given options where we wanted to be able to serve. And most of my colleagues were choosing Shell, they were choosing Chevron, they were choosing Elf, they were choosing Total. Because at that time, as a youth copper, most oil companies, they pay you 350 naira a month, and that was a lot. Apart from your, you know, 200 naira you get from the NYSC. And then when they came to me, I said, I want to start serving deeper life. Some of my colleagues were looking at me. This one is crazy. This is open check, free money. I said, no, I'm serving in deeper life. Most of them went to where they wanted to go. I served in deeper life. I lived in the Genwa Road. And up till today, I came to the church in the Genwa Road in Benin, and we had a lot of young people. Some of them were struggling with their GCSE, with their GCE, you know, O-level, the WAEC. Some of them from 4, from 5. And during that, my 1 year youth call, I helped many of them, you know, told them buy better and brighter grammar. Teach them English, teach them maths, teach them this. And most of them, they succeeded. You know, about almost 10 years later, I was in Lagos, I was in Bagana. There was a sister, ran to me, Brother Shola. I couldn't recognize her anymore because now she was a real woman. I said, you didn't remember Sister Florence? At that time she was in Form 4. But now, she said, now I'm working here, now I'm working somewhere here, I'm married, this is my husband. But she still remembered. You know, the 315 naira, you will spend it. But you can impact lives of people. Don't let money be a criteria for your life. There are things that are better. And that's even very many years back. And I remember during those years, as many, if I go to sometimes when I go to Nigeria for the strategic conference, they'll just be calling me, Brother Shola here. Many students from Ugoma campus, University of Benin at that time, students from Ekema campus, University of Benin, students from, you know, Medical Lab 10, students from